Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome down to another live from me, this time in the interview mode. Many of us are using the lockdowns to be highly creative, finish albums, start new albums. And one such Bedford artist, got the lockdown hair going on here, Mr. Michael Green, has released his first new album of new material for 2 years this week. And he's going to be coming on here in a minute, hopefully, and we're going to be doing a little interview about this album. There he is, Michael Green. You're watching. If you're watching on Facebook, YouTube, get ready. Michael Green's going to be joining. We're back. Come on the Wi-Fi. All the people watching, Michael Green, get ready to join this live interview. It's hot and up, whether you're watching on Facebook, YouTube, whatever. Do you like my lockdown hair? We're going to be talking to Michael Green about his brand new album that's out. There he is. He's coming on now. Let's hope it works. Get your headphones in, Michael. 10 people watching. Here we go. Loving your work. I'll miss you, Indy. Can I interview you? Talk about your album, all your groovy things. We add in Michael Green. Come on, Michael Green. It's going to work. Add in Michael Green. Get that little add-in sign up. It flashes. Ah, love you too, Mel. The guest declined the live video. What? The guest declined the live in video. Yeah, we're adding Michael Green again. Come on, Michael Green. Don't let us down. We're connecting. There he is. Mr. Michael Green.
Hello.
How are you? Well, before we go any further, before we start, how's our echo situation? Have we got it?
No, I can't hear any echo.
Oh, yeah, we're all good. Michael Green, great to see you. Back again on the Effort interviews. How you been doing?
Yeah, been good. As you can see, I've been keeping productive, keeping creative.
Which is what I was just saying at the start of this video. So Michael has got a brand new album out this week. 3, 2, 1. Michael, let's hear what it's all about.
So, basically, with this lockdown, in my head, I was like, I needed something for me to be productive with my songwriting. I thought, well, with me, I tend to write mostly when I've got something to work towards, like a project or something like that.
Yeah.
So I thought to myself, let's just write some songs for projects, like maybe like a live, just do some videos for my YouTube and things. So what I did was over a period of like 2 weeks, just like wrote a song a day, and then like sort of honed it down, and then I did like a sort of like narrowed it down to 7 songs, and then like did the videos.
Well, yeah, I know, and I've been checking some of them out, and you've got, so that's the great thing about creative, you're writing about subjects that are very much non-lockdown subjects and talking about, you know, people interacting and stuff. What was the inspiration for all the songs? Talk us through, is it 7 songs or 8 songs? How many songs is it?
Seven songs.
So talk us through each song. Let's have a little chat about each song on this new record. First of all, what's the record called?
It's called Hold Tight Acoustic Live Album.
Right, Hold Tight Acoustic Live Album. And take us through each track.
So the first song is called Incredible Night. So that's basically just a nice little sort of upbeat sort of pop song. The day I was writing it was literally I was just on my guitar and playing around with like chord progressions. And then like the melody of like the sort of pre-hook bit came in, like you got my jaw dropping to the floor, and because you look like a superstar. So it's about you're on a night out with someone. With a lady, and it's just like you're just having the best time ever, and they make you feel like a maiden.
Yeah, you know? Is this the obvious question? Is this written from experience, or obviously you've had many incredible nights over your life? But
Well, this one it's inspired by previous situations, but it's like it's more definitely in the zone of just like just right. Probably just thinking, I just wanted like a write like an upbeat sort of.
I mean, that's the great thing about songwriting. You can project yourself into a situation. So, yes, ladies and gentlemen, Michael Green has had incredible nights out and many more to come. But I think what you've done, you've projected yourself into previous incredible nights and envisaged this incredible night with an incredible person, lady, and come up with this song. Is that kind of where you were with it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, like, some of my songs I write from like previous experience. Some of them I just write to be in that zone, and where I'm like, as an actor, you try to put yourself into a role and into a situation.
Yeah, and that's what.
You're... So like, So elements of that, and you put them together.
So that's what you did with track one. And what about track two? Let's talk us through that one. What's that one called?
This one's called "I Never Thought I Could Love Again," and it's the premise of, like, for anybody who may have gone through heartbreak or gone through situations where you think, you know, do they feel like it's ever going to happen for them again? And then somebody comes into their life and it's like, oh wow, they've just completely changed everything.
Wow. So so when you were, so is this a predominantly because you play guitar? Did you write these songs on the guitar, or have you
a bit of both? Like this one, I was literally listening to some songs. This was an inspiration, and then like this chord progression came out from the song. I was like, okay, I like this. So I had my piano, my keyboard there, and my guitar. So the first thing I went to was actually the keyboard. So this song that came out of the chords of it, and then the hook came into my head.
And that was how
what happened was, I listened to the song, and then like the hook came to my head while I listened to another song.
Yeah.
And then I basically sang that hook into my phone, and I thought, okay, this is really nice. And then I went to my keyboard, and then came out with the chords. And I thought, it works here. And then I thought, okay, yeah, I'll pick up the guitar and see if it works on the guitar as well. And then I end up writing the rest of the song on the guitar.
So is it like a dual thing between guitar and keyboards? So that's track number two. What about track number three? Let's keep the track by track.
So this is a song called "Here With Me." This was an idea of a song that was previously written before the sessions started for this album. So that was an idea which I had like this on my phone, like the chorus. I thought, that's really nice, really nice. And then I just thought, okay, yeah, let's just go back to that and let's rework that. And that's just a song about like a relationship where, like, say, like, you made a mistake and you basically you're longing and for that person to be back into your life, in the sense of like, what can you do to get them back into your life?
Yeah, I get you.
And I feel like it's one of the most vocally expressive songs on the album. Like, it's one that's very emotive. Like, you just really sort of like vocally.
Process, and we're on the third track, and we'll get to track four in a minute. I know there's videos all up on YouTube. Have you recorded this in an audio medium and a video medium? What about what mediums is going out on? I know there's 7 YouTube videos up for this. Has it been recorded as well?
No, it's exclusively just a live album on my YouTube channel where it could be exclusively heard on there. That was the plan, basically. I wanted it all to be like sort of like a live album, live videos, and then like people just watch performances and this.
Well, which is great, because they can really hear you doing what you do, and, you know, no trickery, just Michael Green live and raw. And that's fantastic. So if you just joined us, we're talking about Michael Green's brand new album that's out this week. It's a live YouTube album. We're going to say this a few times. Where can people find it, Mike?
So you can listen to the album on my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/MichaelGreenTV. And if you go to my Facebook page, which is Michael Green Songwriter, then all the details are on there as well.
That's a fantastic stuff. So we're going track by track. So track number four, talk us through that one.
So this is like, definitely had you in mind when I wrote this. You're sort of, you know, when we're in the studio, we're writing those sort of funky sort of numbers. So I was playing around on the guitar and playing around with some the chords and like some sound. I thought, I like this sort of progression that I had here. And like, it's a sort of like funky, it's a song called "What's Your Name." So the premise is basically you're walking, it's telling the story, walking through a street, and then you see somebody who, like a really attractive lady, and then catches your eye, and you think, okay, you're in that moment, okay, what do I say? How do I go about this? And it's literally just telling that story about in being within that microcosm of that moment.
Yeah.
And it's just a nice little like a funky sort of like vibe of that, really.
The vibe of that. Okay, so that I'm looking forward to. I've had a brief listen to some of it last night. Well, it dropped at midnight last night, didn't it? Is that roughly?
Yeah, it did. Yeah.
What about track number five? Talk us through that one. This is the track by track.
Track number five is the title track of the album. It's where I mean, like, the next two songs on this album is where I dug a lot deeper, and it's about basically being there for somebody who is going through a tough situation.
Yeah.
So the song's called Hold Tight, and the chorus is a Hold Tight, Don't Let Go, I've Got You, Don't You Know. So it's that feeling of like, you may be falling, but I've got your hand to lift you up.
Yeah, I think that's something at this crazy time we're living in. It's a bit of a universal theme that a lot of people can relate to. You know, people need friends, they need, you know, people to interact with, if not in person. So, you know, having a friend like Mike and so writing a song like that is a good thing. You know, so you, it's sort of basically saying about people being there for people, which is a good concept.
Yeah, I mean, definitely, because in this time, like, we're really like, I wanted to come up with some songs where, like, you are, that's whether you're in isolation, whether you're feeling down, whether you're feeling in a bad place or a situation, is like, I wanted to write something that's like sort of like encompassing of what's happening at the moment.
Yeah,
like, you know, and this sort of a little bit deeper of it.
Fantastic. So track number six we're on now. What's track number six?
So this is along the same sort of lines. So this is a song of mine called Lay Your Head.
Yeah.
And this was like the last song I wrote of the whole of the sessions. And this is basically just saying like, if you just, you know, I know you're going through like a tough time at the moment, just lay your head on my shoulder. You know, just be at peace. Try to be at peace with yourself in this situation.
And so that's track number six. And track number seven, the final track on the Live Sessions album.
So, yeah, like, this was literally on my guitar, and, like, I came up just chord progression. It was sort of had a sort of, like, Spanish, like, beat sort of, like, vibe sort of feel to it. And there's a song, Wonder Woman,
basically. Wow.
So it's almost a flip of the other two songs where you're saying that person's there for you. Like, they have your back in the darkest hour, and they shelter you from the stormy showers and that type of thing. So Wonder Woman,
which is an incredible thing. Lots of things come to mind. And Michael, when you were recording this album, you know, these times we're all having to sort of time manage our day and you know, and get things happening. When was the best time for you? Was there any particular time that you were doing these videos, or was it a nighttime thing, or?
So basically the plan was always write the songs, narrow the songs down, and then like properly learn the songs, and then literally do the session in one day. So I did the session last Tuesday I may have done. So I basically just recorded all the videos in one session, and then like just got the videos and get them all sorted, like all edited. And then getting all the graphics done, all the artwork and everything like that, and then like get it up onto my YouTube.
Absolutely fantastic! And in sort of the 24 hours, pretty much nearly since it's been out, have you had some good responses? Have you shared it round? And you've done a bit of stuff.
Yeah. I mean, like, yeah, because at the end of the day, this is the first time I've ever done a project where nobody's ever heard any of the songs before it got released.
I know this. I know. Indie Ford's giving this a good love. Hi, Indie Ford's fantastic artist. We both love Indie. We're going to hopefully do an interview with Indie at some point. But anyway, Mike, this is the first time, because normally when Michael Green makes a record, I've proudly been involved with a few of them now, you'll play the songs at nights, there'll be a period of building up, me or whoever your collaborator is, like learning the songs. But with this one, you've literally, it's an isolation album, isn't it? You've had to write and learn the songs yourself and perform the songs yourself.
Yeah, I mean, because it really only came to mind like the other day. I was like, you know what? Nobody's actually heard any. Because sometimes what I'll do is like I'll record something on my phone, like just guitar and vocal, and send it to some friends and like yourself and some other people, and get feedback and say what do you like? What do you think of this? Do you think it's any good or not? This is the first time where like all songs, like nobody, not one person's heard any of it, and it's like at the end of the day, I can't. They're any good or not, I don't know if people got to help people, any of the songs are going to stand out. All I can go is by my gut instinct and then just see how people react to them. It'll be interesting to see.
Wasn't sure if it paused there. It'll be interesting to see what people think. And it's been a good exercise for you, because you really have to like self-discipline yourself to go, right, Michael, what's the vibe? You know, like you've had no one to bounce off. You've had to literally write songs and bounce off yourself.
Yeah, it's been like, I mean, I don't know if people been seeing in my posts on social media, but I've been saying it's like one of my most creative and productive times that I've had, you know, to have that time to actually properly focus. And like, also when you set yourself a goal, especially with songwriting, like I remember like a few years back, I did something similar with like Johnny Mudd, Fergus.
Yes, I remember that. Yeah.
We had to write a song a day, and we did it for 14 days. And like, so I sort of challenged myself. I said, you know what? I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to push myself to write a song a day and then get to 14 songs and then narrow those 14 songs to 7 songs. And then we're just going to work with those.
Because, you know, just to say, in no way are we celebrating too much this whole terrible time, but there are, you know, in a good old English way or anyway, there's major positives to come out of being focused like this. You know, I'm finding this myself, as you've probably seen on some of my live feeds or projects. You know, never before have I had this much time to just focus on being creative and, you know, like we've talked about on the last interview and I've talked about with many people. First of all, everyone's health is the most important thing. We know that goes without saying the world over, wherever you are watching this or whoever you are. Then after that's the economic thing. But those two things aside, having the freedom to be able to be creative like this is such a beautiful thing. You know, it's such a celebratory thing.
Definitely. I mean, at the end of the day, like, nobody's saying how people should deal with the situation. Like, so everybody's going to deal with it in their own, and that's in their own way, and that's okay. And for me, I mean, this has helped me through this situation, being like having this project, because this has helped me like get through this whole sort of like lockdown sort of like situation. So having the privilege and the creativity of being able to do that to occupy me is like, it's definitely helped me focus.
Yes, yeah, it's a beautiful privileged thing. Dave Farrar just joined us. I think you're involved in the London Underground, so respect to that, because you're probably out there working. I don't know if you are still, Dave, but legendary Bedford drummer. But Mike, so with these tracks that are on this album, just before we wrap this up, are you going to record? Is it going to strictly stay a live album, and then obviously you might jam the songs out and play them? But do you have any plans to take any of these songs and embellish them in the studio at all? Or
yeah, I mean, definitely. Like, depending on the reaction to the songs, it's definitely like going forward. Hopefully, they maybe go into the studio and get some recordings of them. For the moment, obviously, like, I can only do what I've got at the moment, so I'm just going to focus on, because like I said, we don't know how long this whole thing's going to go on for, so I'm just going to focus on, like, just going to be doing some lives. So
have you got any lives coming up that we can talk about, or just any lives?
Yeah, I've got one this week coming up, and then hopefully, if people look at my socials, that will be publicised. And then I've got one in the line lined up with another like a Facebook page that we're hopefully planning on doing for next week. So that'll be all out.
Brilliant. Well, Mike, thank you so much for joining us. And is there anything else you want to say about this record, or anything you want to say just in conclusion?
Yeah, I mean, like, feel free, if anyone wants to go and listen to it, then any feedback, any comments you want to put on, it'd be great to get, like I said, because I don't really know how people will react. It'd be great to get people's reactions, and if there's any songs that are standing out that they like, it'd be great to know that, because it'll just help me going forward, because it'll help me going forward with potentially songs that I may record into the studio, and then also songs which I will be playing live as well. So definitely the feedback will be great.
Well, Michael, thank you so much for taking the time out to do this interview. It's been a pleasure to talk to you as always. Keep checking out Michael Green's music, from his most recent stuff to his classic stuff. He really is a Bedford treasure. And Michael, please keep doing what you're doing, because you're inspiring all of us music, along with all the other musicians that is in our network. You know, doing things like this will just, it has a knock-on effect to everyone. Go on.
Let me say one more thing. Another reason why I've done this album is I wanted to show people that there's no real excuses when it comes to creativity, in the sense that if you feel like you don't have the right sort of like at home, you don't have like a studio.
Lost you. Coming back. Hello, Michael. We lost him. We lost him on the crucial moment. Is he going to come back? Is he going to come back? Still watching. We've lost Michael on a crucial moment. Well, I think we've... Pause. Oh, there we go. Yeah, he's gone. But thank you so much for watching the live. We'll be back with some more interviews soon. That was Michael Green. And I think he was going to say that he just wanted to say that anything could be achieved in the lockdown. And what he's done is the proof. So thank you for watching. I'm Matt Roberts.